I've been getting a lot of emails lately from clients who are worried about the current state of Airtable's API deprecation. If you've received this email, you might also be a little concerned about what implications this has for you. Airtable's API is going through a year-long process to upgrade the API, which means if you have some stuff that was built prior to 2023 that used a lot of Airtable API connections, it might not be working for you in a couple of months. So if understanding this whole process is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you to get organized and automated with no-code tools. Airtable is one of our favorite no-code tools, and we connect it to all kinds of stuff all around the internet, all kinds of different software that we are using that talks to Airtable and gets information from Airtable and updates from Airtable, all thanks to no-code automation. Now, the cornerstone of all of this, the whole point of you ever even caring about an API deprecation like this, it's because you're building some sort of automations, some sort of integrations with other tools. So if that's you, you would strongly benefit from understanding how to build no-code automation. Check out my free training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. I'll include links wherever you found this video, and that training is going to give you whatever key fundamental building blocks of no-code automation you might need. It's going to go through the steps of how you can basically get anything talking with anything else online, and so that you can start automating more and eliminating those repetitive tasks. So grab that free automation training, but without further ado, let's hop into the heart of things here. We got to talk about this API deprecation. Now, first, I want to direct your attention to my email that you've probably received, or at least some variation of this email. So here's what Airtable is saying. Listen, you're receiving a reminder because you're an admin on an enterprise organization, or maybe you're on a pro plan or whatever, but you're using an Airtable API key that is legacy. Now, this came prior to February 2023. We're going to get to that in a minute. But for now, in January, this is again 2023, we launched the new API authentication methods. Now, you can click here. I can include this as well below this video, wherever you found it, if you want to do some light reading, he said sarcastically. Not light reading, it's pretty in depth. We're going to go into the highlights here so that you don't have to read all of that. So as part of this new API key deprecation, users will now no longer be able to create new API keys. This was as of just a few days ago. Of recording. This was sent on August 1st. So the timeline is going to be changing depending on when you watch this video, but here's what they've set up. On Feb 2023, the API key deprecation notice was sent out, basically saying, hey, listen, we are changing over the way that our API works. It's no longer going to be that way. So if you've got questions, now's the time to get them answered. All right, now, August 1st, when this message was sent out, users are no longer able to create new API keys through the old legacy method. So up until just a few days ago, as of this recording, we could still create old API keys, but we can no longer do that. From now on, we can only create the new kind of API connection that Airtable wants us to use and the direction that they're moving toward. Now, this is the most important one because February 1st, 2024, existing API keys cannot be used to access the Airtable API. So what does this mean for you? If you are using the API key that is legacy, the stuff that was available prior to August 1st, you could have created one of these API keys as recently as July 31st, 2023. If you did, that API key will no longer be available after Feb of 2024. So what does that mean? It means that any time that you built an integration with Airtable using that API key, that it will no longer work. You are going to need to update that connection or your integrations will cease to function. That is a big deal because if you're reliant upon information being passed between these different tools, you probably want to cut this off before it happens. So, how does it impact your organization? Again, let's keep just going through this. as a brief update here, API keys and therefore any integration that used them to connect with Airtable will continue to work until Feb 1st. And then to ensure continued access to the Airtable API, you need to start exclusively using new authentication methods before that date. So, is this a big deal? Yes. Is it something to stress out about? No. Let's just go in and make sure that we refresh all of our connections. I'm going to show you here exactly how you can set up the new API keys and how they are different from the previous ones. So we're going to go ahead and pop on into our account here in our account settings, load it up. You will see when you do this that you get this little notice here. API keys will be deprecated. They're letting us know everywhere. So that's great. We're no longer going to use API keys. Let's go to the developer hub and see how we can establish these new keys. So here is my old key. Here it is. API keys will be deprecated by the end of January 2024. After this date, API keys will stop working. Okay, so if I were to click in here, this is my key. This was like total admin permissions, right? This did all the things, and I could just use this key to get my Airtable to talk to other software. So if you're wondering what an API key is because you've not ever used one, or maybe it's just never been clear to you, this is like a personal phone number, if you will, that gives somebody information and connects two pieces of software together. So you can think of it as like a private password or something like that, where if I want to build an automation in Zapier or Make, or maybe I want to create a document in Document, or maybe I want to have a connection with a form software like Fillout. Well, all of these different options are available only because I can connect my software. And so when I do that, that software is gonna ask me, well, what's your API key over there at Airtable? How do I know what Airtable account is yours, and how do I know where I should be passing information and all of that? So that's where this key comes into play. Well, we no longer have these keys. The new one is a personal access token. Let's go into how we can create this. So all I have to do here is click create token. It's gonna take just a moment. And you can see that I've already built one token for my softer customer portal. Now I named it this. So whatever I chose to name it here, that's what it's gonna be brought up. It's gonna show us what access this has. Now the cool thing about the personal access token is we can actually say much more specifically what we want it to be able to do. So let's go ahead and create a token, and I'll walk you through step by step what this looks like. First and foremost, we need to give this token a name. So let's say I wanted to create an integration with my fillout. For example, I have a cool form in fillout. So I'll say this is my fillout token. Now we are going to go into the scope of what we want it to be able to accomplish. So you'll notice that when I go in here, I can choose what type of information can be passed back and forth. What kind of permissions am I granting to this particular token? Now for us, maybe we just want it to be able to read data in our records. Maybe we want it to be able to write data. Maybe we want it to be able to read comments or write comments. So these are our different record data and comment options. But then we can go down deeper into base schema. Maybe we want this API to be able to look at our base schema or write to our base schema, or for more advanced things, manage webhooks, manage blocks. So all kinds of options here, even enterprise options like reading at the group level, user groups, or reading at the workspace and bases, or writing or managing all of this data. So long story short, you need to make sure to grant those permissions that you want your key to be able to do. If you need to look at certain information or create certain information, you have to grant this token the right permission or you can't do it. Now, most of the time when you're setting up this integration, like if I were doing this in Fillout, Fillout would tell me specifically, this is the kind of information you're gonna need to include for that token. So for our example, let's just say I wanted to be able to read and write records in Airtable. I would simply make those selections here. Data records read, data records write, I'm good to go. I can always add more of these permissions and eliminate them, but once the token's created, it is what it is. So now I have to also tell it, the next step, which is what level of access. This token can access the following bases and workspaces, and you only grant access to bases and workspaces that you have access to. So I cannot grant access to stuff that I don't have access to. Because I'm an admin, of course, of this particular workspace, I can do pretty much everything. But if you were not an admin, that's the advantage of this. You can only give access to your personal access token through your existing permissions. So I can add bases. I have a whole dropdown of all of my bases, and I can also add a whole organization. So boom, one click, bring the whole thing in. For our example, let's say I just want to bring in one particular base. I create my token. Now here's where things are a little different. This token is only available right now. Let's check it out. It says it right here. This token will only be shown once. Copy it now and forever hold your peace. Store it in a safe, secure location. Put it on a password protected file or something like that. Whatever you do with these things, you will never get access to it again. Literally never again. So only use this token for your own development. Don't share it with any third-party services and applications is what they're saying here. You can go ahead and copy this with just a single click, and then done. We are done and we're good to go. Now, if I were to go back and try to access this again, yes, I can update what this token can do. I can remove things, I can add scope, but notice that even if I make these changes and save the changes, I never get that token back again. It's quite literal that that's it. Like, I cannot change or bring back or re-access that token. The only thing I can do is go back to my personal access tokens and scrap it, delete it entirely, and start again, create a new one. I have no option here other than regenerating the token. But anytime that I do this, if I regenerate the token, it's going to break any connections that I built with the previous token. Again, think of it as like a secret password. Anytime that I regenerate it, it's going to nullify any connections that I already have. So what does this mean? Well, you have to go in and create this token and ideally create the token uniquely for the different things that you want to connect to. When you get connected to Zapier again, when you get connected to Make, when you get connected to Softr, connected to Fillout, all those amazing third-party tools that you integrate with Airtable, build a token and then make sure that you've done this before Feb 1st, 2024. I know that we covered a lot in this video. This is a pretty important topic. If you have questions, be sure to drop them below wherever you found the video. And in the meantime, keep on building.